In this short video, we will learn to change the topology or geometry of a facial studio head using 3ds Max. So, I'm creating a 3D head for the sake of this video, and I'll apply a default material to it. If you look at the wireframe that we have at the moment, we have a default wireframe structure that works really well with all of Facial Studio's 500 built-in deformations. But you might not be happy with this default wireframe. So, what I want to show you is a very quick workflow. Let's apply an Edit Mesh modifier. And if I'm to move some points just to fix some of the wavy wireframe we might have because of the current deformations applied in Facial Studio, you might want to smooth out the points and adjust the look of your characters, since some of the deformations can be modifying these points. As you can see, doing so is very quick and easy using 3ds Max's modeling tools. Now, when this is done, when we have adjusted our wireframe in the Edit Mesh modifier, we still have access to all the parameters that are available in Facial Studio. So if I am to go back here, open the mouth, or make it smile, we can see that the deformation that we apply on top is still applied. You can also use the same features to select the jawline of your character and turn it into a beard, for example. And we will do so by simply extruding some of its geometry. I'm selecting the polygons one by one, but you can use any technique you wish to make this selection. Now that I have the desired selection of polygons in my Edit Mesh modifier, I'll just make sure that the Extrude and Bevel section is set to local, like this. I can then extrude these polygons a little bit and use the Move tool to make some adjustments. I'm currently adding polygons, or adding more geometry to my character's mesh if you prefer. I'll then just smooth this out a little, like this. So, I've created an exaggerated beard mesh for my character, and now, if I go back in the stack, we can see that all the built-in facial deformations are still fully functional, even with the new polygons we have just added. So using Facial Studio, we can still combine the numerous options that are available within 3ds Max's stack, and we can apply a modifier to deform the geometry, and add or remove polygons on top of Facial Studio, to really deform the geometry to suit our needs. Thank you for watching this quick overview on how to modify the geometry of Facial Studio heads in 3ds Max. Please take note that this feature is not available in the trial version. Feel free to download the trial version of Facial Studio at www.di-o-matic.com.